Hello, in this video we're going to talk about vitamin B4. Now, did anyone ever tell you the first B vitamin that was ever discovered? Do you have any wild guesses? It's B1, then comes B2, then B3, and then B4, okay? And the name of B4 is adenine. So what does it do? It basically helps prevent nerve paralysis or a loss of nerve conductivity, primarily to the heart. The research was actually done on pigeons, by the way. Now, also, when you have this loss of nerve conductivity, you're going to have a loss of coordination of the muscles of the heart. And there's four parts of the heart. You have two primary pumps and two major pumps, their ventricles, and they all have to be in coordination. So when you have a deficiency of B4, you get this loss of coordination. So if you look at a heart graph, you'll see a split sound or a delay in the heart sound. The eventual end result of chronic B4 deficiency is fibrillation. And the last function of B4 is it prevents an enlarged heart. So if you don't have the nerve flow to the muscle, it loses tone, and in the chest it starts sagging. And if you look on an x-ray, it's getting bigger because it's lost tone. And when you lose tone, the valves open up and you get leaky valves, and that's murmurs. Okay, what causes a vitamin B4 deficiency is refined flour products in the form of bread, pasta, cereal, crackers, biscuits, waffles, pancakes, and also refined sugar. So the way you would get vitamin B4 is in nutritional yeast. Okay? Thanks for watching. So this Thursday night, I'm doing another live Q&A at 7 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So bring your questions Thursday night at 7. Let's chat.